Good morning everyone. In the previous lecture, I explained you different kinds of epithelial cells and various kinds of connective tissue. Today I'm going to explain you muscle tissue. We know that muscle tissue can contract as well as relax. This is the basic feature of the muscular tissue, contraction and relaxation. This property helps in body movements. Muscle tissue further divided into three categories: serrated muscle, unserrated muscles, and cardiac muscle. Serrated muscles are also known as skeletal muscle, striped or voluntary muscles. Skeletal means those tissue which are directly attached to the skeleton. Stripe means in the structure of muscular tissue there are alternating dark and light bands. Or voluntary muscles are those muscle which we can control by our own will. Unserrated muscles are known as smooth muscle, unstriped and involuntary muscles. Involuntary muscles are those which are not under the control of our will. We cannot control them. They walk by their own. Cardiac muscle, it is a special involuntary kind of muscle which is located inside the heart. Cardiac muscles are shorter and they do not get tired soon. Here you can see the different kinds of muscle. The very first, serrated muscle, second one unserrated, and the third one cardiac muscle. In unserrated, here you can see the dark and light band, sarcolemma, that is a protective sheath of the muscle. Nucleus is present. Unserrated muscle, it is a long tapering from both sides. Cardiac muscles are branch. Nucleus is also present in each muscle. Uninucleate and serrated, striped, alternating dark and light bands. Next one is the neural tissue. Neural tissue constitutes a nervous system. It is made up of a special cell, neuron or nerve cell. Further, neuron contains three main parts: cyton, dendrites, axon. Here you can see the diagram of nerve cell. This one is the cyton. Cyton is also known as perikaryon or soma. It is the main body of nerve cell. Inside here, nucleus is present. Further, cyton contains hair-like extension called dendron. Dendron is further branched into dendrites. Long extended part downward side from cyton is called axon. It contains nucleus, a protective sheath, neurolemma, myelin sheath which act as an insulating sheath against the dissipation of energy from masses. Nodes of Ranvier, where myelin sheath is not present, the term is used nod of Ranvier, and the exocell covering the nerve fiber. At last, axon ending. It is also known as the terminal ending of the nerve cell. Here at this point, next nerve cell starts. Between the two cells, there is a gap. It's called synaptic cleft or synapse. Synapse is the meeting point or junction of two nerve cells where exchange of masses from one nerve cell to another nerve cell takes place with the help of a chemical neurotransmitter. Neural tissue basically concerned with perception and responses. It helps in transmission of messages from one part to another part in an encoded form.